Good morning everyone. So this is your English literature period and today I'm going to teach you a new poem by Robert Frost that is Stopping by the Woods on a Snowy Evening. Okay? So the poet is Robert Frost and name of the poem is Stopping by Woods on a Snowy Evening for class 7th. So let us begin. Stopping by woods on a snowy evening. Whose woods these are, I think I know. His house is in the village though. He will not see me stopping here to watch his woods fill up with snow. My little horse must think it queer to stop without a farmhouse near. Between the woods and frozen lake, the darkest evening of the year. He gives his harness bells a shake to ask if there is some mistake. The only other sounds the sweep of easy wind and downy flake. The woods are lovely, dark and deep, but I have promises to keep and miles to go before I sleep and miles to go before I sleep. Okay? And the poet name is Robert Frost. Okay, so the summary of the story poem is a speaker is in the woods but he is trespassing. Trespassing is moving. He first wonders who owns these woods. In the same breath, he tells us that he thinks he does know who owns them. The lucky landowner lives in the house in the village. So our speaker won't get into trouble for trespassing. Why? Because he knows that there is no one who is going to catch him because the owner of the woods live in the village. Our speaker has a horse and this horse is little. Our speaker psychoanalyzes his little horse, tries to understand his little horse and supposes that the little horse must think it's pretty strange for them to be stopping in the middle of nowhere because they usually used to stop somewhere where there is a resting place. With no one in the sight, with not even a farmhouse close by and absolutely no sign of the hay. The speaker and his little horse are chilling between the frozen lake and the woods. And what are they doing there? They are not ice skating over there. No. Also, it happens to be the darkest evening of the year. The little horse is starting to really lose it. Why? Because it is very dark and he is very confused about the fact that why they have stopped over there. Fortunately, he has some harness bell. Harness bell is something that is around his neck. And he gives them a little shake in order to get his master's attention. The only other sounds are the sounds of the slight wind that is blowing and the falling snow. So it is very quiet. Now the speaker is saying that he admits to be having a hankering for the dark woods. That is, he loves dark wood, but he tells us he has got things to do. He has got many things to do and people to see and places to go. And he has to go to different places and he has to go to different people. He has got a long way to go before he can rest his head on his little pillow. And he says that he has a long way to go. Because of which he can't stay back into the forest. Though he is loving it, but he can't stay back. So this is how the poet concludes saying that he has plenty of other things to do. And as a matter of fact, he can't stay back. So with this, we end the class. Hope you all have understood the poem. Once again, thank you everyone.